Hello, thank you for joining me. Today I'm at RSPB Middleton Lakes. I'm going to be doing a little bit of a macro adventure walk today. I'm just going to see what's about. It's nice and early. There's been a bit of a rain. We had a lot of rain last night, so we had a bit of a thunderstorm. So I don't know what to expect. Like I said, I'm at RSPB. RSPB doesn't always mean birds that are in the sky. They boast about giving nature a home, and believe me, they do. Here at RSPB Middleton Lakes, it's absolutely vast. They've got fields, woods, they've got that much and that many trails to go. Believe me, I've been coming around here now for the last 3 years and I can't get around all of it yet because I keep stopping because there's that much natural beauty. So you'll love it here. The paths are nice and flat. They're a bit bumpy sometimes, but it can take you on average 4 hours to actually walk around the old place. If you stop and start like me, it could probably take you the whole day. So if you do decide to come, bring a packed lunch because it is a big place. So I'm going to be looking today for bugs, insects, water drops, flowers, anything that takes me out. A lot of people walk around this place, and because I think it's an RSPB place, that they've got to look up in the sky. What they're actually missing is what's underneath their feet. So today I'm going to have a walk around and see what we can find. So I hope you stay tuned and I hope you join me on this macro adventure. When you're taking pictures of daisies or anything like that, what you want to really try and do is use the plants as your background. So you're shooting through, but you've got more to them if you do this, because it's like putting a daisy in a picture, but if you've got other daisies and blared out in the background, it gives you a better, subtler look. So this is what I tend to do, is I find me a patch of daisies that I like, pick one out, put my eye to it, and then take the picture so it draws everything through the daisy. And I quite like that one. So I've come across this next little great little find. These are teasel, and they make absolutely beautiful pictures. They're really spiny of plants, but when they're edited on a moody background, they look absolutely beautiful. I think I'm going to give these one a shot. Beautiful. Don't know about you, but I always do one for good luck. I've really got a thing with daisies at the moment. I'm really liking the textures. This one, because we're so early of the morning, it's got water droplets on it. So I want to try and emphasize the daisy with the water droplets, not just because it's water droplets, I've just got a fascination with the center of daisies. What I'm using today is a simple setup. I've got my 7D today. I've got my Godox flash. This is set at 164 for the power. I'm currently, my soot settings at the minute are, when I get them up, is 1/60th shud speed. I'm at F8 and ISR 100 because I want to give it, you know, I just want to draw it through. I've got one of Jan Bell's diffuser on. This is just to help soften the light. I mean, I know it's bright today and I'll probably get away without a diffuser, but I just want the diffuser on just to make sure if I need it, because there's nothing worse than not taking one or not putting one on, and then you come to a shot and you realise, damn, you need a diffuser. If it's a bug or something interesting that can fly away straight away, you're losing that shot. So I'd rather have it there, set up and ready. So I've just stumbled across this bumblebee. He must have been out all night and got caught up in the rain, and he's absolutely soaking wet. This is where you find, usually can find butterflies as well, but with the rain last night, it really has put a dividend to the butterflies. So I think I'll take a little picture of him, but I just hope he dries out. But it's getting warm now, so it should actually dry out. Not too bad. Dry out, little man. You know I can't miss a shot like that. Little bit of a dandelion, that rain's washed, a dandelion flower should I say, that the rain's washed it all up, left a few on. Ideal opportunity, out in nature. Got to get this shot. If I didn't get that shot, unbelievable. I've just come across these lovely yellow flowers. Might be a bit bright for you to see, I suspect, with the sun hitting it. But these look really nice, and they just, how they stand out really takes my fancy. Now, I know I'm not going to need the flash for these, because the way the sun's hitting them and the light is on them, there's no need for it. So what I'm going to do is just take a shot of it. But like I said, I'm going to use the flowers at the back to give me a more vibrant background and a nice more textured background, so when I edit it them. So I'm gonna have a go at one of these. One more for good luck, like I always say to you. Not too bad. The yellow and the sun is really blowing the colours out, so I don't think this one will actually make good for a good picture, but we'll never know until we get home and we have a look. Thank you for joining me today here at RSPB Middleton Lakes. It's a fantastic place. Like I said to you earlier, come out, enjoy it. It's not all about the birds up there. They boast about their insects and wildlife and giving them an home, and believe me, the RSPB Middleton Lakes really do. The helpers, all the volunteers are absolutely fantastic. If you want any help, they'll give you the help. They'll even tell you where to go and find the insects or find the bird that you want. So it's a cracking place. And like I say, okay, I didn't see much bugs and insects today, but I sure did see my wildflowers, and I'm happy with the pictures I've got. So if you enjoyed it, please subscribe, please tell your friends. If you want me to do any more of these videos, please let me know. I'm open, I will do them. Just leave me a comment in the box below. And don't forget, if it's your first time here, please subscribe, help my channel grow. And until next time, everybody, stay safe and happy snapping.